The Simpsons. Got to ask about The Simpsons. Please. The Simpsons are one of the biggest influences. You are in the space. The Simpsons and Mr. Show, Conan O'Brien are some of my biggest influences. Conan O'Brien worked with you on The Simpsons.
Yes.
You went to Columbia. Did you get made fun of a lot on The Simpsons?
No, not really. No one had.
They're all from
Harvard.
It
was a bunch of autistic Harvard guys. They didn't really know I existed. The room was like this. Turn to page 3. We need a new line for Homer. Silence for 7 minutes as the world's greatest minds tried to figure out a piece of original comedy that would last 100 years. Right? It was the most crushing, intimidating room in the world. Sometimes they would make jokes, and the room would laugh, and I wouldn't even get it. I would later look it up. The first time that happened was somebody goes, Monticello, I thought you said Montebello. And the room erupted in this fucking nerdy historical laughter, and I went home and looked up what that was.
You soaked that in, and yesterday I watched Homer versus Patty and Selma.
Oh, thank you.
And your writing in Homer versus Patty and Selma, first, it's one of the best episodes on The Simpsons. I think it's season 6. I wish I could have annotated, but I was like, I can't for them, but for me, I want. There were so many just like silly, stupid, smart, like you just said with the Monticello, Montebello, was so good throughout that episode. You clearly soaked that up through your time with.
No, that episode was written by the room. And
okay,
so
then let me ask you about
that,
the process of the room. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You're in the room, and they say, we need 23 episodes this season. Mm-hmm. You take on a couple of them. Mm-hmm. Right? Is it just riff it out as far as the plot, then you go put down the dialogue? How does that work?
Roughly speaking, yes. You start out group. The group comes up with the story. One writer is sent off to write a draft and then brings the draft back and it's punched up. That's the basic pattern.
Okay.
So you get your time to write a script. That's the precious time for a writer. We get to leave the room. And some writers...
Is that in the office too? I mean, like, you're in the room, you do the room, everyone riffs, then you go to your little space, you go to your corner... You knock it out?
Yes, usually.
How long does an episode take?
Well, it used to take, you'd be given 2 weeks to do a draft. Now I find mostly shows will give you 1 week to do a draft.
Wow.
Yeah, and then you bring it back to the room. At The Simpsons, we got 3 weeks, I believe. It was considered quite indulgent.
Sweet luxury indeed. Favorite episode you didn't write? Now, you wrote 3 episodes that are in Rolling Stone's top 100.
Wow.
Lemons of Troy.
Wow.
You were part of the 22 Stories.
Yes.
And Homer Palooza.
Yeah.
And Homer Palooza.
Nice work.
Thank you very much. Yes. That's without the notes. Favorite episode you didn't write?
I would point you to a very pivotal episode of The Simpsons that was before my time. I wouldn't necessarily say it's my favorite, but just for your comedy knowledge.
Thank you.
Conan O'Brien wrote an episode of The Simpsons that changed the show. Conan O'Brien was a great writer before he was a talk show host, and he wrote the monorail episode.
My favorite episode.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what happened there was the Simpsons was a fairly realistic family show that was animated. The key influence there was Jim Brooks, who was the that's right. people who still hate Jim
Keep
Brooks.
Keep that in the show. That's funny.
Jim Brooks, you know, he was grounded realistic comedy. He influenced a very grounded, realistic animated family show. That's what The Simpsons is,
right,
until the monorail show. Conan O'Brien realized that you had these tools at your disposal, that you could do very surreal stuff. And with the monorail show, he just changed the whole tone of the show, and it became like crack to the other writers who were like, we can do episodes like that, and the show, boom, exploded into a new style.
You get these 30-second chunks that it's like there's 5 jokes in a row,
sure.
And the callbacks are ridiculous. And I mean, I call the big one Bitey comes to mind within mm-hmm. that episode. Mm-hmm. The scientist guy shouldn't have stopped for that haircut, or anything with Leonard Nimoy,
uh-huh.
right? It's like, and I say that may the force be with you, and he goes, do you even know who I am? He goes, I think so. Aren't you one of the little rascals? I mean, like, everything.
Wow.
But, yeah.
That's
yeah.
very interesting to watch a Simpsons episode just play back.
I could do.
Your
I could probably.
That's
I could probably
amazing.
Do the whole thing. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Very impressive.
Very, very kind.
Unknown speaking talent.
Of,
the guy.
My favorite.
Just,
my favorite line.
Autism.
My favorite. That's Rostism. My favorite line though has to be when the guy tries to jump off the monorail and he's like, oh no, it's Krusty. No. There's 2. Krusty tries to jump off the monorail, and then Leonard Nimoy pulls him back, and he goes, the world needs laughter. That line I always love. And then there's also, what does Leonard Nimoy say? Oh, there's the lunar eclipse, and he goes, I would do all of this for Conan, by the way. I'm sorry. I just love it way too much. The lunar eclipse, because the monorail is solar-powered. And then Leonard Nimoy goes, the cosmic ballet goes on. And this dude by him goes, anyone want to switch seats with me?
Yeah.
I've always...
But do you know any King of the Hill quotes?
Okay.
No, I'm just amazed he's doing the voices. Go,
you know, God damn it, Bobby.
When I was a writer at The Simpsons, I found that if you could do the voices of the characters, you could get pitches into the show more easily. Oh. And I could never do any of the voices except for Marge and Grandpa.
Go!
I used to be full of piss and vinegar. Now I'm just full of vinegar.
Yes!
Marge is...
Oh, homie, I don't understand.
Someone in that vocal.
That sounds like the Bart version of Marge, which I always love.